everyone, and welcome to Python Pop, a series of quick videos explaining different Python functions and commands. And in today's video, I want to go over how to make a simple dot plot. And what we're going to do is we're going to leverage the knowledge that we gained on making simple histograms to help us make these dot plots. So let's go ahead and copy over some things from our simple histogram code, which I'll leave a link of a card on the side so you know how to access that simple histogram video that we've already went over. But first, since we're going to be graphing, we want to import matplotlib and we want to import random, since that's how we're going to create our data. So if you remember from that video, we created a list of favorite numbers. So we did a simple loop and appended a random integer 0 through 9. And let's go ahead and print out what we've got. And there we have it. So that's going to give us a list of length 20, where we're appending that random integer 0 to 9. Now, how we did our histogram was we have our count, our bins, patches. Our important keys here are the count and those bins. plt.hist, we're putting in our favorite number list and we're giving it the bins 0 through 10. We're aligning this on the left, and we had also outlined it in the video. So when we do plt.show, we're going to see that histogram. Now, a histogram essentially keeps track of the count of our data. So if I was to print out our bins, and I was to print out our count in, you can see our bins go from 0 through 10, but remember, the bin is between 0 and 1. So starting at 0 up to 1, that captures all the numbers 0. Starting at 1 up to 2 is our second bin. And then all the way up 9 up to, but not including 10. So notice that this is a different length than this list here. And again, that's because we made our bins 0 through 10 so that we could capture those values of 9. But what this gives us is our data point values and the frequency at which they occur. So we can simply plot with plt.plot our bins by the count. But again, like I stated, these are different sizes, so we need to pop or remove this last value from our bins. So what we're going to do in order to remove this last element or pop it, right now we have an array, so it's not a list, so we don't want to go that pop route unless we convert it to a list. I'll leave it as an array, and I'm just going to simply say that bins is equal to the value in bins up to that very last number. So we don't want to include that 10. And there we go, 0 through 9, and then the count for each of those values. So when I go to plot this with plt.show, right now using plot, that's going to create a line connecting 0, 2 to 1, 1 to 2, 1. I just want to picture the dots. So I'm just going to simply say the style is going to be blue and I want a dot, B-O. So when we show this, all right, so we have dots. But notice that we only have those max values. We don't have all the dots represented underneath. Because if the frequency is 2 for 0, meaning that two individuals, their favorite numbers were 0, we want to see two dots, not just the dot at the level 2. And we can do this with a simple for loop. Because we have all of our information we gathered from our histogram. We have the bins and we have the count. And how we're going to do this is talking through it. We're going to loop through each of these bins, taking in points for the count. So we're going to make an X list and we're going to make a Y list. Notice here for this value 0, 2, that represents that two different people like the number 0. But if this is a dot plot, we want a point to also be at 1. So we don't want just want 0, 2. We want 0, 2 and 0, 1, which is going to correspond to two different points. So we would want to have 0, 0 in our x list and 1, 2 in our y list respectively. So how we're going to do this is we're going to loop through this bin. The nice thing about this bin is that the value is also the same exact index for the count. So when we're at 0, in of 0 is 2, which gives us the count for that value of 0. This is going to make looping through this list fairly easy to relate to the count list. So we're going to say for, we're going to put our value x for each x in the bins. Again, that's going to be 0, 1, 2, 3, all the way up through 9. Every time we get to one of those, we want to look at the corresponding count value. I'm going to put a placeholder count and start that as 0. So while that placeholder count doesn't equal the actual count of our x, then I want to append the x value to the x list and append the count value to our y list. So x list dot append is going to get our x value, and y list dot append is going to get our count. So let's talk through this. When we loop through our first bin, x is going to be 0, the count is going to be 0, so 0 does not equal in of 0, which is 2, so we're going to append 0, and then we're going to append the count, which is 0. But I don't want to start at the number 0, I would rather start at the number 1. So let's just switch this number to count equals 1. So now I'm going to look here, I'm going to see that my frequency is 2. I'm going to append the value of 0. I'm going to append my count of 1, so I'll get that 0.01, and then I want to increase my count by 1. When I increase this count by 1, I'll go back up into my while loop. Count will now be equal to the value of 2, since we started with 1. Now we're adding 1, we're going to get to 2. But now we have an issue, because 2 does indeed equal in of 0, which is 2. So we're going to skip through this, not appending that next point. So I just want to increase this by 1. So let's go through this again. Starting with the count of 1, we'll see that 1 doesn't equal 2 plus 1, which is 3. 2 plus 1 is 3. So we're going to append 0 and append 1, then increase our count. Then, now count will be 2. 2 doesn't equal 3, since we added 1 to that value of 2. 2 doesn't equal 3, so I'm going to append 0, and I'm going to append 2. Then I'll increase my count. Now 3 does indeed equal 3, so we're going to skip over this, then continue to our next bin value for x. Another way we could have done this is we could have left the count as 0, left this as in of x, and then just appended the count plus 1 so that we don't start with 0 getting appended, we would append 1. So that might have been a little less code, but as far as the frequency goes, this tracks. Now, as opposed to plotting my bins and my count, I want to plot my x list that has tracked each of those bin numbers, and my y list, which stores those different points to capture each of the frequencies. So now when I run this, there we have it, our dot plot. 1, 2, this has a frequency of 1, 1, and then you can see these 4, 5, 7, and 9 all have frequencies of 3. This will look very similar to our histogram, just now represented as a dot plot. Feel free to remove the axis and this grid, since the dot plot only has one axis. And you know what? Let me do that really quickly just to show you if you want help. PLT dot the y ticks. We just don't want to show those tick marks, so let's go ahead and set that as an empty list. So there we've gotten rid of those tick marks. And one simple way to make these dots appear closer is to just change those y limit values. So PLT.ylim, I'm going to set my minimum value as 0, and let's go ahead and set that maximum value as, well, our frequency is 3, so we know that max value that's currently displayed is 3. So if we change this to 5, those dots will appear closer together, or if we even make it 10, it will start looking more and more like that dot plot. So feel free to play around with other ways to customize these dot plots. And if you know another way to make a dot plot, feel free to let me know in the comments below and I'll check it out. But again, this was just a quick demonstration on a very simple way to make a dot plot. If you have any questions, feel free to also leave them in the comments below. But as always, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Happy learning!